When using optical modules, you may notice labels like 1310nm and 1550nm. What do they mean? They actually refer to the wavelength of the optical module. So what are the differences between them? First, the link loss is different. For 1310nm modules, the link loss is generally calculated at 0.35 dBm per kilometer, while for 1550nm modules, it's about 0.20 bm per kilometer. Next, the chromatic dispersion is different. On G652 single mode fiber, the dispersion coefficients of 1310nm and 1550nm optical modules exhibit substantial differences. 1310nm modules have near zero dispersion, meaning the signal won't suffer significant dispersion during transmission, reducing signal distortion and inter-symbol interference. In contrast, 1550nm modules have relatively higher dispersion, around 17 picoseconds per nanometer kilometer, which becomes more noticeable in high-speed data transmission. Additionally, they use different types of lasers. 1310nm modules typically use FP lasers, which have a simpler structure and lower cost. 1550nm modules usually employ DFB lasers, which add a grating structure to the FP laser design, enabling narrower spectral line width and higher side mode suppression ratio. As a result, 1550nm modules are generally more expensive. Because of these differences, their applications also vary. 1310nm modules are typically used for transmissions within 40 kilometers, making them ideal for metro access networks and intra-data center connections. On the other hand, 1550 modules are suited for longer distances, up to 150 kilometers, and are commonly used in long-haul OTN networks and high-capacity DWDM applications. Alright, that's all for this video. If you found it helpful, please give us a like and subscribe to our channel.